So let me write the program for this algorithm, which is bubble sort. So let me write the function def bubble, and the parameter will be the array which I want to get sorted. Okay. First, let me compute the length of this array. So for length, there is a function len of a. It returns the length of any list which you provide there. So length len of a will return me the length of this array or the list. So I will write my first loop, which is for I in range of n, which is the length of the array. So first loop should go until the number of elements in the list. Okay. The second loop should start from the first element, but after all the swapping, see what was happening here. So after all the swapping, the maximum element was going to the last position. So in the second pass, we don't have to compare that element or include that element in the comparison. So we can safely exclude the last element which we got in the last pass. So every time we will exclude one such element, and in such way we will get the sorted array. So the second loop will go for j in range. It will start from 0, okay, but it will go until n minus I minus 1. Minus 1 is because of the range issue, because we have to go until the minus 1 part. And minus I is that when the ith element, and when the maximum element gets to its the last position, then we have to exclude that element. For that I am putting minus I. So it means that when I is 0, it means it's the first iteration. It means there is no maximum element which went to the last position. So we have to go to the last element in the second loop. But after I becomes 1, it means that one of the first maximum element went to the last position, and we have to exclude it. So for that n minus I is required. And after when I becomes 2, it means two maximum elements, first maximum element and the second most maximum element, went to its correct position. It means nth position and n minus 1th position. So we have to exclude it. So that's why this condition is required. Then I just have to check the condition which I was talking about. If a of j, it means the current position, is greater than a of next position, which is j plus 1, if such thing happens, then just swap it. So I will create a temporary variable temp, and I will assign it the value of aj. In aj, I will put a of j plus 1, and in a of j plus 1, I'll put the temp variable. This is just swapping of two elements. That's it. That's all my program should be. My sorting is complete. Let me just create an array a, which I gave in the example, which was 5, 1, 4, 2, 8. Okay, this was my array. I will call my function bubble and pass this array. Let me print the elements of this sorted array for I in A. That's it. I'll print I. Great. My program is complete. I'll just run it. Cool. 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. So my array was 5, 1, 4, 2, 8. I got 1, 2, 5, 4, 8, which is 1, 2, 4, 5, 8, which is sorted. So you can create your own array, and you can run this program, and you will get the sorted array. So this is how we perform sorting. This is one of the algorithm. This is not the best algorithm that we have. There are so many better algorithms. For example, quick sort, merge sort, heap sort, and so other sorting algorithms. But this is a basic algorithm which you guys can use if you do not know much about sorting. And after you learn more of the programming and algorithm and data structures related things, then you can go into the more advanced sorting algorithms, so that your time it takes, your function takes less amount of time in order to sort an array. Thank you.